It feels good. Packed a few things in my bag, and it's time to head out. Go and meet up with a couple of guys now down in the mountains of Cebu, and go for a ride. So I'm just blasting down the coastal road of Cebu, and gonna head about an hour south and meet up with Vince and his nephew, who were in the last video trying out the CRF 300L, and they're gonna show me a few mountain roads today, so it should be good fun. So I'm looking forward to it. I've just put a couple of things on the rally, and that's what I'm riding today because I wanted the extra fuel range, because I'm got to drive a little bit there and back to get to these mountain roads, and that's what the rally's for, right? Hey,
hello.
You beat me to it.
Yeah. Two minutes.
Ah, yeah.
That's very far.
Oh man, we're not too far away then. That's a twisty road down there, isn't it?
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, I like it. Yeah, just a couple of times like you think it's good, and then suddenly the surface just goes, and you go, oh yeah.
There's a couple of places, but then all the way up and down into Argonne and other cities, it's the same.
Yeah, yeah, it's nice. Yeah. So we just met up at the crossroads here, and had a quick chat, and now we're off to down towards Osmeña Peak and Bajin Highlands. So yeah, enjoy the ride. Now it's nice because I haven't got to navigate today, because these guys know where they're going, so I can just enjoy the ride. Oh, look at the view out there. That's looking pretty cracking.
There's some nice views from here.
Some beautiful views, yeah. God. Look at that! Oh man! You're heading right down into the valley. God, it's like autumn in the UK here. So many leaves on the floor. Oh, we're into the valley. And we're heading there. Look at this hairpin. Different world down here. Wow, some turns, isn't there? Well, basically heading into the jungle here. What a road. And we got a river. I want to cross it. Look at that. I'd have never have gone down there.
We were... See the road, remember the road I said, where does that track go?
Over yeah, we're there. It's across there, so we're over there somewhere.
We went up there.
Yeah.
You just come right down.
God, it just drops down, doesn't it?
The other side.
That drops like anything.
Oh, something.
Look at that down there. Have you been on that in the wet?
Yeah.
So, because I noticed a lot of leaves down.
That bridge was, that's quite new.
Okay.
I came through here when there was no bridge, it was like a little ford.
Little ford?
Yeah, it was great.
I was looking at it, I think I said on the video, I went, I want to ride through that.
Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah.
And the next time I came back, there's a bridge out. Oh, come on.
Yeah, I know, yeah. I mean, that's your epic adventure river crossing, isn't it? They're taking it away from you. Just got to get past the goats crossing the road. Move out the way, boys. Oh, this is remote. This is properly remote now. Just little houses for, I guess, people farming. Why, the rally loves this kind of stuff. We are in the middle of the hills. Oh, this is a nice little track here. I like it. These are the kind of tracks that I just love here. Look at that vista as you come over the top there. Eyeball that. Wow, I'm getting seriously low on GoPro battery, but look, we're right next to Osmania Peak, the highest point in Cebu now. Well, that was pretty stunning, Osmania Peak. Dropped the bike in the car park. So I can tell you one thing, the rally is easy to pick up. And easy to pick up. It's super light. So that's one bonus, I found that out. But yeah, beautiful views up Osmania Peak and around this way. And I'm glad I got hand guards and crash guards put on at the weekend. It didn't drop it fast, obviously it was only a car park drop. It just went over on its stand because the car park was just loose gravel and the side stand just dug in and dropped. So a side stand foot is going to be on order because that's no good. But dead easy, dead light to pick up. Pretty stunning, huh? Now we're making our way down to a little cafe with a beautiful viewpoint apparently, and then we are going Badgin Highlands, which is a, I don't know what it is, don't know what to expect. Look at that out there. I mean, that's almost could be Switzerland. Yeah.
I want that coffee place. Did you see it? Same for the coffee. Coffee and shit.
Did it? I didn't know, missed that. Coffee and shit. Ah. That'll be the food, the shit. Oh wow, we are right in the middle now, right in the middle of all the little peaks. A little update, we've been riding about 4 hours. We've gone to, well, through a lot of the mountains in Cebu and up to Osmeña Peak, and also had a quick stop at a little cafe with a fantastic view, and now we're heading, I think, on this Badgin Road, which by all accounts is going to be pretty spectacular. Well, oh, look at that. a stunning view. I'll try not to crash and I'll give you the view. Wow, what a ravine. And we're coming down right through the middle of it. Oh, look at that road there. Meow. Look at that. Holy moly. What a road! Wow.
That's the tourist spot.
Ah, okay.
It's a nice view there.
What, you going up to it? Look at this. Wow. is the challenge. Let's go see what this road's like. They've both been telling me that it's pretty steep and pretty rough, so I'm looking forward to this bit. But look at this, guys. I mean, I don't know about you, but this kind of riding in this kind of scenery on these kind of roads is right up my street. Slow down, men at work. Look, they've actually just blown straight through this. They've blown straight through the mountains and the rock faces to create a road through the middle. And it feels pretty claustrophobic in here, actually. But pretty amazing. Gonna give Vince a little bit more room. This is where it begins. Ah, it would be slippy in the rain, this I can tell. I don't think this is going to be a problem. Okay, drop down a gear because it is slidey. My back wheel is just sliding. Oh, the back wheel is just going out. I mean, not gripping, literally not gripping. I think you'd be better off going fast on this, boys. It's just, it's like sand. That was just, I mean, my back wheel was basically sliding all the way down there. I like it. Oh yeah. Back wheel is just sliding out. You can see Vince's back wheel sliding out and mine there. As soon as I give it some. Get on the front a bit whilst we're straight. This is not for the faint heart to come down, because you are locking the back wheel. You got to know your back brake, but I love it. He's happy he made it without dropping. You made it look easy. He's really happy with that because his tyres on his XRM are not great. And if you looked at Vince's CRF 150L, his back wheel was sliding out and so was mine. But as long as you're not scared of a little skid, no problem. Don't fancy, well, I don't know, I was going to say I don't fancy it in the rain, but it'd be a bit of a challenge in the rain. Bit of fun though. I'd like to go up it. I And here's your reward.
I had a little bit of heart attack there. For impact.
For me that was okay, but the back wheel's just going.
Yeah.
But it's okay. What about this one? Where does that go?
That's too dangerous.
Look at him on his blue scooter, he's loving it. I tell you what, I'd like to go up that on a CRF, on this or on the 300L. Yeah, that'd be fun going up. Man, there's some views here. Now we're back onto beautiful cement. Oh, make me laugh. Said he was braced for impact. He thought he was coming off because he was sliding all over the place. I mean, my back wheel was doing a little dance down there. There was no traction whatsoever. Been going for about 5 hours I have now. And still got loads of fuel in this rally because it's amazing on fuel economy. 28.6 kilometers per liter. I've used 3.5 liters so far. Wow. Look at that view. Straight onto Badgian Island and Negros Oriental behind it. Canlet on volcano up there. Beautiful. God, this is a good road surface now. What are them on the road? Do they say you bounce off the railing? It's interesting. Well, I better catch those guys up. I'm too busy videoing. We just come back down from the mountains now, and we're heading back up north to Rhondda. So we came out of Badgian, so we just got a few kilometers up on the national highway to get up to Rhondda, and then we'll depart ways and I'll head back home. But it's been a great ride. This kind of ride is exactly the reason why I ride. It's you know, you're in the mountains, you're stopping to have something to eat. You know, guys here are showing me different routes that I've never seen before. And then, you know, next minute we're down at the sea. It's just a really, really good ride. And the rally, I'll be doing a review on that later this week. I'll be doing a 1,000-mile review. So stay tuned for that, because I think I've pretty much done most things that it was designed for now. I've done 1,329 kilometers at the moment. And I've done some longer rides, shorter rides, play rides, off-road, tracks, everything really. Everything that the rally's designed for. So yeah, stay tuned for that one, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. And yeah, do all that other stuff, like, subscribe, notifications bell. We're actually planning a few trips I think we'll be doing some inter-island trips. Inter-island trips! Sounds far, doesn't it? But I'm certainly planning a few trips up to around to different islands. I want Leyte and Samar, Luzon, Mindanao as well. So stay tuned for those, because there's going to be a whole travel series coming, and I'm just fine-tuning what types of videos that I'm going to be putting out for you guys.